As the dirt are softened and deepened by the rain that's falling.
away, some infirmity away. Stay dry. Just hang out with the devil. He thrives in dry places. Jesus cast the demons in Luke 8 out of a man in Galilee. Thousands upon thousands, legions of devils went into the pigs. As Jesus commanded them to go, they left the man, went into the pigs. The pigs run down the steep and begin to drown in the water in the lake that was beneath. Devils were homeless again. See, demons have to have a house. Demons have to have a place of abode. They don't like being homeless. Ain't it amazing those demons got out of a man, but the pigs ran down and drowned in the water. But now the demons were homeless again. I can't help but think out of this man. See you when the devil comes out.
Verse 7, you got to back up to verse
verse 6 and practice it. Come on, somebody. You got to humble yourself under the mighty hand of God. What's it mean to humble yourself? To humble yourself means, God, I'm tired of trying to make it happen. I'm trying to do it on my own. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Lord, I humble myself and I declare tonight, without you, I can do nothing. John 15 and 5. Holy Ghost, tonight you're the rain. Tonight your rain reigns. And I thank you, Holy Ghost, for coming down upon those who have humbled themselves. Who have humbled themselves and are now casting their care upon you. Because they're aware that you care. You care for us. Lord, I thank you don't just care about us, but you'll take care of us. Somebody lift your hands tonight like you don't care. Come on, somebody. In that pop culture back in the 80s, those rappers used to come out and sing, lift your hands in the air. Like you just don't care. Well, you just don't try that tonight. Come on. Come on, let the care be on him. We're in a season of miracles. We're in a season of a Christ mass or a Christ celebration. A celebration of the manifestation of the incarnation of the Messiah, Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. We celebrate the anointed one and his anointing. We celebrate his power and his person. His ability, his enablement, his endowment to overcome every adversary in our life. We celebrate with our hands extended to that Lord in this season of the miraculous. Because God, you said in Isaiah 9 and 6, the government shall rest upon his shoulder. Somebody ought to let it be on his shoulder right now. Come on, somebody. Somebody ought to shift the load from your shoulder to his. How'd I do it, Brother Marvin? Humble yourself tonight. Lift your hands. Just obey the voice of the word of the Lord coming through my mouth. Just be obedient to the simple instruction. Come on, instruction is given so you might act in obedience through faith upon it. Because God never does a thing until he says a thing. And then those who hear the thing that was said, do the thing that was said. Come on, just do the simple things tonight. And God will do the marvelous things. They'll follow if we do the simple ones. Come on, lift your hands in this place. He's coming back. Hallelujah. Sow to yourselves in righteousness, reap in mercy, break up your fallow ground. For it is time to seek the Lord that he may come and bring righteousness upon us. It's time for you to come.
And for 14 years you walked with pain.
life support and let hurting, come on, stop, lay hands on them and call their spirit back. And 2-3 days later, they woke up and didn't know nothing nobody said, but they remembered I came. They knew it was Marvin that said they heard my voice. They didn't hear nobody, but they had dreams while they were calling. And they saw me and they prophesied to them over me. It was just God using me. I've seen God do through my life is when I was so desperate for one myself. So the Holy Ghost told me this week, he said, Marvin, I'm calling you in this season because I recall in your mind someone I did through your hands in the past, and you were so desperate for a miracle yourself. He said, I'm calling you in this season before the very day that we celebrate the Messiah's birth. Come on, somebody. He said, I want you to go proclaim the miraculous. Come on, somebody. He said, because I'm going to heal through you again in this season. The Holy Ghost told me a few days ago, I was at my mother's and I was behind a chainsaw for 2 days. I think I'm still a little sore. But I'd cut down one tree and I'd sawed it up in logs and sawed off short limbs, and I was carrying them and I was in pain in my body, and I went to throw, hallelujah, amen, one piece of the tree into the bush. And I began to weep and cry and I said, Lord, I still believe. In spite of my pain, in spite of the diagnosis that can't be found, come on, in spite of what I don't understand, I still believe. I don't see you do too much now to not believe. Come on, somebody. And I said, God, I'm not asking for a miracle because I'm trying to believe. I'm asking for a miracle because I already believe. See, some folks asking for a miracle because they want God to manifest so they can trust. That ain't faith. No, those who really got faith in God ask for a miracle because they already believe. I don't need to be persuaded that he knew. I'm already persuaded. I know in whom I have believed and am persuaded that he's able to keep that which I've committed unto him against the day. 2 Timothy 1:12. I'm persuaded. And I said, Lord, I still believe for my miracle. And the Holy Ghost replied to me. He said, Marvin, I'm going to do the miracle. And you understand, for I've called you to preach it throughout the years, that everything you're wanting me to do is already did. By my stripes, he were healed. 1 Peter 2:24. Somebody shout, the Holy Ghost already healed the devil. Somebody shout, King Jesus is already ahead of your affliction. That means before you ever got sick, my God, I just felt a wave of his glory. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. I felt a wave of the miraculous right there. Come on. How do you hear this truth? God said, before you ever had need for my healing power, I already assured it. Not on this tree. Not on this tree, but Calvary's Christmas tree. Calvary's Christmas tree with the light of the world hang. Jesus the Messiah. And by his stripes, not a red ribbon, but a red stripe. He already purchased it. Somebody shout, if you were healed, well then ye are. Somebody shout, we're not dealing with ye are sick. We're dealing with ye are healed. Hello, somebody. Some people sometimes just see her sitting in the shadows and in dark places. Come on, somebody. I believe sometimes people look at you, First Lady, the same way. But if it weren't for y'all, come on, man of God, you know, if it weren't for them, sometimes ain't nobody to prophesy to me. Man, I get texts all the time. I get stuff on the internet all the time. Pray for me. It's every day of my life. Brother Marvin, I need a miracle. God, I need to pray. And I don't know how to tie. I'm ever hearing about it. Say, Brother Marvin, you need anything? Hey, man, come on, man. I've got messages from people that were so desperate before me being the floor, crying out to God, so desperate myself. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. And there's been other times going to God where I just felt like, God, what am I going to do? But here come my wife. Hallelujah. Lay hands on me or speak something. But sometimes I'm weak, she's strong. Sometimes I'm strong and she's weak. The other day she said, what are we going to do? I said, we're going to do what we've always did. We're going to trust God. Come on, somebody. Somebody told me one time, I said, well, you got great faith. No, I said, no, I don't. I just ain't got no other choice. refuse to be kindness. I refuse to be purpose. Hallelujah. I started talking crazy. I was about to say, you ought to try. According to